crew in to introduce in sections.
Right.
The Cabinet Affairs staff first, Mr. President. This is, let me get out of the way, Don Clary.
Hi, good to see you.
How are you?
Ed Stuckey and Rick Davis.
Hi, good to see you.
How are you, sir?
All right.
Ann Wenzel.
Hello there. Nice to meet you.
Dawn Murray.
Hello there.
Just fine.
Mary.
Hello there.
It's a new.
Nice to meet you.
This is Nancy Finnegan, who's come with me from Commerce to Treasury to here.
Nice to see you.
Jennifer Brandenberry.
Hello there.
Just joined us.
It's good to meet you.
Patsy Farrow, you know?
Oh, yes, I do. Hi, how are you?
Would you like the camera?
Yes, you can.
All right. Mr. President, it's Ralph Bledsoe. He's the Executive Secretary of the Domestic Policy Council. He's full of all the option papers. Like,
to see
Ralph, why don't you introduce all the people who work for me?
Mary Beth Reardon, Mr. President.
Mr. President, hi, very nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you.
This is Fran Seidel, President.
Hello, there. Nice to meet you.
Mary Segulis. Mary's been here a long time.
Hello, Mr. President.
Nice to meet you.
And Bob Sweet, Mr. President.
Hi, Harvey. Good to see you.
Mr. President, this is Eugene McAllister. He's the Executive Secretary of the Economic Policy Council.
Hello, sir. Good to see you.
It's an old heritage man. Gene, would you step over here and introduce the rest of your staff?
This is Sharon McCaffrey. She worked on the campaign.
Thank you.
They're going to want you.
Wait, hold on. Can you step back?
Nice to see you.
This is Penny Wise, Mr. President.
Hello there.
This is Dina Cruz.
Well, nice to meet you.
And this is Tim Hauser,
Mr. President. Nice to meet you.
Good to meet you. Well, now, I understand we have two group photos.
Yes.
All right.
I'll go right in there. Right in the center.
Now we're starting.
Mr. President, you're going to do your photo here, and then we'll move the second group over once you finish here.
Now, if everybody can squeeze in as tightly as possible.
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Well, frankly, that's my index.
Oh, yeah, we all set on the side first. Over here.
This is the camera.
Okay, thank you.
The camera doesn't believe in that.
Those of you who might not get in here for some time, you can see this is sort of a Western border.
Yeah.
So I can get through and sit in the rain. So it'll be on the ground here. See, now the very interesting thing is that that display of saddles, Warren Annenberg has loaned us those. It's an artist that in bronze has done the history of the Western saddle. And it begins with a Spanish war saddle of about 1514, but then comes on and include the Cherokee Indian version of the saddle.
That's
a
new saddle?
Huh?
Is there a new saddle? Is it just the Western?
This is just the history of the Western saddle. You see, it was a very interesting thing when they first began running cattle over here. In Europe, running cattle, why they did it with a whip and they did enter the fences. Well, out here, they didn't. Have the fences and so forth. The whip wasn't going to work very well, so they invented the lariat. And then the saddle they were using was a kind of a Spanish saddle left over from the conquistadors, which had sort of a big rounded dome in the front of the saddle. But with the lariat, the first time somebody hooked a calf or a steer out there with the lariat, and then found himself sailing from the they figured, and then they whipped it in a notch around that dome that they could quickly dolly the rope, and that is what led to the horn. So,
President, you're late
for
4 o'clock.
Thank you.
Place else to go?
And it does. Good to see you again.
Good to see you again. You brought some people in.
Yeah, I did.
But I'm the other trustee.
Well, hello.
Well, gosh, yeah.
I'm a senator from Arizona. Well, I want to tell you, the vice president made that speech yesterday at the airport. I've never heard of it. Hey, well, that was a good one.
Mr. President, Darwin Kent.
Hello. I see you're pretty patient to wait this long. 1983.
My pleasure.
Well, thank you. And here, I understand that we have some citations to read.
Yes, sir. Mr. President, the first citation is for the Honorable Barry Goldwater, who we all know is not only a great pilot, but a great guy. The citation is as follows. This award, the Harmon International Aviation Trophy for Aviator, was presented to Senator Barry for over 200, for flying over 200 aircraft types during an aviation career lasting 57 years. His flights in such airplanes as the hypersonic Lockheed SR-71, the world's fastest aircraft, the British-French Concorde, SST, and the Bell helicopter, XV-15 tilt rotor, have acted to advance aviation knowledge immeasurably.
Well, I'm very proud. I thought I knew everything about you, though.
Oh, that's
that many airplanes in 57. You weren't a kid, though, were you?
Yeah, I flew with it.
Thank you very much. Well, it's a pleasure.
And Mr. President, we have one other. This one is awarded to Aviator Norman P. Kent, senior experimental test pilot for the Bell helicopter Textron, pilot in command or co-pilot on all major flights of the XV-15 tilt motor research aircraft since 77. The tilt rotor combines the vertical takeoff and landing capabilities of a helicopter with the cruising speed and efficiency of a turboprop aircraft. You present that?
Well, I'm very pleased and proud to be able to present this to you. As I say, you're pretty patient because I know when this was awarded quite a while ago.
Mr. President, I appreciate it very much.
But it's my honor. I plead for your signature.
Second lieutenant of horse cavalry to be in. I didn't say that. All right. Thank you.
Mr. President, I'm going to keep that pen.
I want to just say one more word. Okay. Excuse me.
For the president, don't you?
Huh? Yes. Yes, in fact, we have something for you.
Because we want you to be the first to receive this. Joey and I want you to be the first here to receive this. Joe, why don't you help me here? November 1st is the kickoff. For Up, Up, and Away is Arthritis Foundation is a benefit across America. Yes, okay. And we're going to release balloons.
The balloons, so we can read them.
So, what we're giving you.
Well, I'm very pleased and proud to receive these.
I think we should try it over here. Is that good? Can you see?
That's great.
So, you don't have to subscribe.
But I will, and I told her it was going to go forward with the conversation program.
It's going to be the right program. We appreciate it.
So very much.
Well, listen, I appreciate all the feedback.
Isn't he a fine young man?
Yes,
he has his own computer, and he's a very bright young fellow, I'll tell you.
And you're being a big help to about 40 million people in the country.
Thank you.
Mr. President, I wonder if you could get just a separate shot with Joey, and one with Victoria, and one with Peter Nathan.
Yes.
I'd really appreciate it. Let me just get Joey here with you, and let's take those over here. Just get one.
I'm tired of being here.
You come here. I want you all to get a separate shot. Where's his mother? And let's get the brother in here too. Get very often. Get one.
All right.
Get in here, Steve. There, that's great. What a good-looking family. Well, thank you. Let's get one with Victoria now. Let me take Joey, and I'll move Joey and wheel him out. Now, Victoria, why don't you get one with the president? I want Peter Mayfield.
I do.
All right.
And once again, so much. I'm so pleased about this, too. Thank you.
Mr. President, the number one advocate for arthritis in America outside of Victoria, I want him to have that picture with you.
Please. Now, just one minute. I have a few things to do. First of all, in here is a jar.
I'm going to get that
seal in there. And inside the jar are jelly beans.
Uh-huh. All right, look at that smile. Isn't that great?
Mr. President, Joey and I made a deal. If you gave him jelly beans, he'd give me the black ones.
Hey, those are my favorite.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Well, listen, you're all more than welcome. Please have you all here.
Thanks so much, Eddie.
Thanks a lot.
I appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks. Well, we're going to show him the cabin.
He didn't get a souvenir because he's in here too often.
I got him on.
All right.
Bye, Joey.
Bye.
Bye.
Jerry, hi.
This
how are you?
It's so nice to see you.
Good to see you.
This is Orlando Ray, Mr. President.
Hello there.
This is Kelly Calloway.
Kelly, hello there.
This is Brian Lovett.
Hi, how are you?
Good.
And this is Humphrey Taylor of Lou Harris Associates.
Hello there. Good to see you.
Mr. President, we very much appreciate this opportunity and the many young people to see you. And we also want to tell you a little bit about something very important, not only in terms of their lives, but in terms of the lives of many people who have gone through our boys' lives. We, about a year ago, decided it would be a great thing to strengthen our accountability by having a survey made by an independent firm to find out if our alumni really had received the benefit from the club that we believe they did receive. Mm-hmm. And Humphrey Taylor made this survey, and he did a fine job independently of us, and he came out with results that just made us elated. They were so good.
Well,
he's going to mention one or two of them, but if you would give him the opportunity, he'd like to tell you about two or three things that were important.
Mr. President, I think the results of this survey are almost as dramatic as your own very high ratings in our poll and in other polls. We found that the overwhelming majority of alumni say that membership of Boys Club had a strong and positive impact on their lives, that it helped them to socialize and get on and work with other people. Overwhelmingly, they say that it helped them to keep out of trouble with the law. Indeed, that's the number one thing that's mentioned spontaneously. They say overwhelmingly that it helped them to avoid problems with drugs and alcohol. Their work career and working prospects were enhanced. Indeed, we find that the two-thirds of them are in professional and white-collar and skilled working jobs, even though most of them came from rather poor, underprivileged homes, that clearly it had a tremendous impact on their ability to work successfully, to earn a good living, to have a full life, and thereby to enrich the whole community. So it's really a remarkable set of findings.
Well, listen, I congratulate you.
And I have the honor to present you with this survey, summary of the whole survey that Humphrey's associates did, which is, I think, you might find very interesting because it has those facts and many, many more about what has happened to our 3.5 million alumni across the country.
Well, and your goal now of a million, I certainly hope you make it. And I just wanted to put in writing.
Well, I appreciate
my
that very much.
Congratulations.
We do want to have it grow and have many more million, another million youngsters, I hope, we can get in the next 2 years, and that's what we want to try to do. And with your encouragement, I'm sure it can be done.
Well, all right, and now, since you presented me with the report, I just have a few little things here. Devote to each of you a pair of cufflinks with the presidential seal on the souvenir, and the two young men tie bars, because I know you don't always wear t-shirts, tie bars, and the young lady a pin, because you won't be wearing it. Well, I'm glad to see you, and I think it's just great what you're doing.
Well, thank you very much, sir, for this
what
you've
achieved.
All right.
Good to see you all. Right here.
Right.
Oh, yeah. I just thought these were all for you to wear. These are for me. Well, thank you very much. I don't know what it's going to wear one. Thank you very much.